Hi, it's Lisa Rapacki with Sit Mofo Sit, and I want to tell you a story about one of my clients. So this family is amazing. They are legit people. I don't always love people, but this couple I really love. And they had this Pomeranian, and they absolutely adore this Pomeranian, lived a long, amazing life. And so they got it from a breeder, and they just love this dog so much. So they decided that they were older and they didn't want a puppy. So they were going to rescue a slightly older dog, something that they didn't have to potty train and all that. And they got another Pomeranian because the love of their life was a Pomeranian. So they got another one. And this dog, the dog's name is Skylar, and was rescued from Korea. And he's got one eye. So as you can imagine, that can do a number on you when you can't see out of that periphery. And dogs really use their vision to constantly checking out the world around them. So he's down this one eye and he has become aggressive. Also, he's a street dog from Korea. So never had any, never had any of that. Never had three squares and a dry bed to lay in also. So here's one of the awesome tips that we're teaching him. So they have a slightly active house. It's not crazy active, but they like to have their neighbors over often. And what is happening is the dog is perfectly content and the neighbors are coming over and they see this cute, I mean, this dog is legit adorable, cute dog. And they immediately, everybody's first reaction is, oh my God. Well, that's terrifying. And that would be even more terrifying if you were coming at me from this angle and I couldn't see you. If that were happening, I would bite you. So the neighbors are also awesome. So we are teaching Skylar to lay in his dog bed. We've positioned the dog bed so that his good eye has full view of both doors, the back door and anybody that would come in from the front door. So he can totally see as he turns his head. We've also instructed the neighbors to not just come into the house. It's one of those amazing neighborhoods where neighbors just like come into people's houses. We've instructed the awesome neighbors to give a knock at the door. So what we are currently teaching Skylar, you're gonna love this. Whenever there's a knock at the door, Skylar is absolutely allowed to bark, but the next response is go to your bed. So knock, knock, knock. Skylar, go to your bed. Skylar is running to his bed. Right now, there's an open floor plan, so it's just from the kitchen and the living room area. But in no time, if they're upstairs, I have no doubt that they'll be able to say, Skylar, go to your bed. And from wherever they are in the house, Skylar will just run. It's simple repetition, but awesome and problem solved. None of the lovely neighbors are getting bit. And slowly but surely, Skylar is learning that not all people suck. So, problem solved. Simple solution, tons of repetition. All right, go walk your dog and click the like button. Please offer any comments or questions down below. You can always find me at sitmofosit.com. You can always subscribe to this channel because I have lots of amazing people and dogs in my life and interesting stories. And you can find me Instagram, Facebook, all of that. It's down below. Go check it out. Go walk your dog.